those cracks and coming into the ground. The rainwater, like the river water, is dissolving away our limestone rock. It's oftentimes making things like sinkholes at the surface. And then that water continues to move into the ground, and as it's heading further into the ground, it actually is starting to pick up enough limestone. Our river water that once flowed through here. And our river would actually completely fill our passageways to the ceiling here. So it's a lot of water down here flowing through here, and the water just gets pushed into the cracks and holes here in our rock. And it starts, you know, dissolving away those cracks just like the rest of the cave. And it usually just creates smaller holes like this one here. Today, although they look a little different than this one. This one had a hard cone-shaped shell. Our cephalopods today no longer have those hard cone-shaped shells, and there's things like squid and octopus. Where do squid and octopus live today?
Are there any elevators in the cave?
No. Nope. No elevators. yeah, there's at our other entrance you actually go down a couple points.
Didn't wonder you want to have a little baby in the pop.
That'd be scary if that room was having more fun.
Don't. flat shelf-like feature, which is where the name shelf stone comes from. It just follows that water surface. The other formation surrounding our pool. These grow down in a pool of water. So where we're seeing them today, well at your house though and don't have city water, which is usually the case if you live out the country.